What drives you, exile? Is it justice? Revenge? Honor? No. It is power. Your limits will be tested. Break them. Do what is thought impossible, and the Atlas will follow.
Alright boys, so if you've been procrastinating and you still haven't chosen a league start for 3.13, then I've got the information that you're looking for. We're going to go over each of the builds that I suggest for your league start real quick. We're going to give you some information on what each one is capable of, what it excels at, and all that kind of good stuff. So remember, I am going to be live for the league start, so when the league is starting, if you want to have something to listen to while you go and push all the way through all those levels, make sure that you come follow me on twitch.tv/bigducks. We're going to be live. I'm most likely going to be playing a Toxic Rain Trickster. I think it's going to be one of the better builds for pushing into the end game, finding out this Maven fight, and figuring things out. So remember guys, if you're enjoying my content, make sure that you like this video so that you can see more of it. Also, over 75% of you, a huge percentage, are still not subscribed to this YouTube channel. Make sure that you subscribe so that you can get these videos right in your feed. Now without further ado, let's get into the video. Alright, so we're going to start out with what I think is going to be the best guide for new players. Also, if you have been maybe away from Path of Exile for some time and you want something easy to come back to, we are going to be getting with Creeping Frost Occultist. This build has a couple special things about it. It can scale to 3 to 4 million DPS with almost no gear whatsoever. It is very new player friendly, it's very easy to play, and it is also extremely safe. This doesn't do the most boss damage in the game, however it does kill bosses very easily because it slows them so significantly. So talking about the general stats of this build has excellent clear. The bossing is okay, as I said. It isn't super fast, but it does actually deal with them quite well. The gearing on this character is extremely easy, and the difficulty of it is extremely low. So if you're looking for something to kind of give you just a smooth leveling process, maybe as something as a first character that you might transition into a higher character later, or just something that you want a really easy time pushing through the content and having no issues whatsoever, Creeping Frost Occultist is probably the build for you. I've used this myself multiple times for league starts, and I've always been very happy with it. So remember that I do have a full build guide for this. It's going to be linked up in the top right corner there. It is going to have a full path of building with all of the info that you could ever need. The build guide will tell you everything that you need to know. It's got step-by-step instructions on pretty much everything. So check out that video, and if you don't like the look of this one, let's move on to the next build. So this next build that we're going to be talking about is the Toxic Rain Trickster. This is going to be my personal choice for League Starter because it excels at boss killing and it is very, very safe while doing so. This build is one of the ones that can scale quite well into the endgame. However, it does work pretty well without any gear as well. This build has some of the easiest leveling, especially early on. It doesn't require any specialty gear. You can legitimately make it to maps on a white 4-link shortbow that you can get very early on in the game, no problem whatsoever. If your goal is to really push into that high end game content, you really want to see like the Maven fight and all that kind of cool stuff, I think that this is probably one of the better choices, simply because it is so easy to get into the end game to push very quickly. Talking about some of the general stats of this build is an excellent boss character. It is one of the better bossers in this entirety of this list. It is very tanky, very easy to play. It also does have pretty good clear. The clear isn't like amazing, it's not like spectacular, but it is quite good actually. And beyond that, pretty easy to gear. However, I think that with this build, this is one of the ones that's going to allow you to work with very low levels of gear, but also scale very high if you'd like to. So remember, as always, there is going to be a full build guide for this. It's up in the top right corner right here. So make sure that you click that if you're looking for the build guide for this build. And remember, there's going to be full path of building, all kinds of notes, all kinds of good stuff in that video, so make sure that you check it out. Now, if this build didn't do it for you, let's move on to the next one. Now this next build we're going to be talking about is the Purifying Flame Mine Saboteur. Now if you haven't actually tried out a mine build, this might be the one that you should give a shot. This build is excellent. I was really, really close to choosing this one for my league starter. I was very, very close, but I leaned toward Toxic Rain Trickster just because I think that the Toxic Rain Trickster will have a little bit more ease of movement, and I kind of like my builds to be able to move around. That being said, this build is excellent. The amount of damage that this build can do with the amount of gear that it needs is ridiculous. Almost no gear and insane clear, insane damage. It is also extremely safe. You can get up to around 7,000 life on this build if you want to push it. You can also get a ridiculous amount of damage. This is a mine build after all. And with figuring out that you can use left click for mines, it's honestly not that bad to play it anymore. I used to not like mine builds, but if you've been on the fence about a mine build and you haven't really, you know, thought that you wanted to do it, give this one a try. It's very, very good. You've got tons of recovery, tons of damage, tons of defenses. This build, if I had to give it some general stats, it is excellent for clearing. Probably one of the best clearing builds on this list. It has pretty solid bossing. I'd say like right below top tier when it comes to bossing. Very, very safe on those bosses as well. This is very easy to gear. It is extremely cheap to get everything that you need. And the difficulty of play is actually relatively easy. Bossing does take a little bit to get used to because you have to learn how to do the blast chains. But besides that, it's a very simple build to play. So remember, as always, there's going to be a link to the full build guide up at the top right corner of the screen, so make sure that you check that out. It's going to have everything that you need, a full path of building with notes and items and all kinds of good stuff over there, so make sure that you go give that video a watch. Now, if this build didn't do it for you, let's move on to our next one. The next build we're going to be talking about is the Poison Blade Vortex Assassin. Now, I know a lot of you are probably going to be saying, but Big Ducks, the Poison Blade Vortex Assassin got completely nerfed. It's terrible now. What are you doing suggesting this? Well, 2 points to that comment. One, it's going to be fine. It wasn't nerfed so hard that it's not going to be a build anymore. This build only lost maybe like 8 to 10% of its damage. We already did a ridiculous amount of damage before, so it's not like we're going to have any problems. And on top of that, I have a feeling that typically, communities overreact and overcorrect to these kind of things, and the two builds that use the main weapons for this build both got nerfs. So typically, the community is going to be like, oh, well, those builds got nerfed. I don't want to play them anymore. So I think that potentially the gear for this might be cheaper. So if you haven't given Poison Blade Vortex a try, this might be the time to do it. Let's talk a little bit about the build itself. This build can do all of the content in the game on very, very cheap gear. You can start out with simple obliteration wands, which are like one chaos early on, and then you can swap over to some other crazy gear later if you need to. But the general stats of this build, excellent clear. This has very top level clear. It also has top level bossing. This build is about in the middle when it comes to gearing. You can get most of the content done on almost nothing, and then when you invest just a little bit more is when you really get that like boss melting DPS. And as for playstyle, this is a super easy build to play. You press right click, you run through the enemies. That's pretty much it. So if you're looking for just an overall solid build that can do just a little bit of everything, this is probably the one for you. Remember that I am going to have a full build guide up in the top right corner here. It's going to have full path of building, full notes, all kinds of good information about leveling and all that kind of stuff. So make sure that you check out that video if you're interested in playing this build. And if none of these builds have done it for you, let's move on to the final build. The final build that we're going to be talking about today is Ball Lightning Archmage. Now, I'm going to preface this. This build is a little bit more advanced. This is meant for not a new player. If you're a very new player, I suggest that you choose one of the other ones. Because this build, while it is extremely powerful and probably the most powerful out of all of the builds on this list, it is very, very not new player friendly. This build requires some interesting mechanics that you have to use. It also requires some specific gear. I want to give this build the highest clear rating that I possibly can, some of the highest bossing that I possibly can. However, the gearing is going to be a little difficult, and the playstyle, the difficulty of this build is very high. This build requires that you spam a mana flask constantly. It is a Archmage build. It has excellent recovery, excellent defenses. We're talking like 8,000 effective health pool if you use like the Clarity Watcher's Eye and everything, as well as multiple thousands of regeneration per second, tons of defenses, all kinds of good defensive layers, insane amounts of damage, and with Harvest coming back, you can scale this build to the top. This is one that will be able to absolutely do all of the content in the game if you decide to go with it, but just keep in mind it is a little bit tougher than some of the other choices on here. So remember, if you do want to play this build, there's going to be a link up in the top right corner. It's going to be to the full guide for this build. It's got a full path of building, full notes, full information on leveling, all that kind of good stuff. Make sure you check out that video if you want to play the Ball Lightning Archmage. And that's it, boys. Path of Exile 3.13 Echoes of the Atlas is basically here. I am going to be live, remember, so follow me on twitch.tv/bigducks. It's the best way to see, maybe find some cool stuff that I'll be doing. We'll be testing out all of the new ritual stuff. We'll be testing out a whole bunch of cool stuff with the Maven. I really want to push into that end game as soon as I possibly can. I really want to see this stuff because it seems really cool. And I kind of want to get to do some harvest crafting. It's been a while. So remember, guys, if you enjoy my content, make sure that you like this video, subscribe to the YouTube channel for more content similar to this, and stay safe out there in Rayclass. And I'll see you guys in 3.13 Echoes of the Atlas.